The last image I wanted to show you, because this is also a social process. This is a project in the agricultural part of the Netherlands where the water is sometimes threatening to flood the agricultural area as the rivers get higher. So the government had said, okay, we're going to take this area and let it flood. And the farmers who live there on these farms said, wait a minute, we don't know anything about this. What do you mean you're just going to let our area flood? We'd like to have some say in this. And this was an interesting social process. This is the only project I know in the Netherlands where people actually were up in arms against the government process, not just because they wanted more money, because they were going to be evicted, but no, because they said, we want to think along with you. We want to think what could be the best solution for us here with our farms. We farmed here for generations. We want to give a proposal and think about what the best way would be to deal with water in this area. And they came up with a proposal together with a Dutch landscape firm, Slobbers & Bos. And they decided to move the farms out of the agricultural area. This dike along the river has been lowered. This dike is still in place. And the farms have been moved to mounds along the lower dike. And of course, mounds, higher ground, were the first way ever that the Dutch defended themselves against water. So I think it's really interesting to see how in a social process of government working together with citizens, we're finding new ways, which are actually very old ways. Sometimes the old ways are actually the best, aren't they? Putting existing functions like agriculture back on top of mounds, and then, as you'll see from this image, keep an eye on these farms, and on the next image, you'll see what this will look like when the river does flood. The agricultural land will flood, but the farmers will be up on their mounds and they will suffer no damage. And when the water recedes and they go back to growing their crops. This is resilience, this is flexibility. Marina Barrage, of course, I thought this was a beautiful example of designing for water. It's a storm surge barrier and also a separation between Sweet and Salt at Marina Bay, but it's not just been designed as an engineering facility. It's been designed as a welcoming public place. And I think a beautiful job has been done here, and I understand that this is a very popular place for people to come and have a picnic and be close to the water. And I don't have an image here, but we'll show one later, of Bishan Park, which of course is one of Singapore's prime examples of redesigning what was just a functional concrete channel to become a place that can absorb more water, higher water, lower water, and to bring people back to engage with water. It's no surprise that Singapore's water project is called ABC, Active, Beautiful, and Clean. And I think particularly the A of active is something that the Dutch can learn from Singapore. The Dutch are trying very hard to get their citizens engaged again in water issues. But I think for the last 50, 60 years, the Dutch feel that government should take care of that. Engineers have taken care of that. It's not our responsibility as citizens. And I am convinced that the Dutch can learn a lot from the way Singapore is bringing citizens in to be engaged and bring them back to the water.